Interpreter of Melodies is a book collection of nine short stories by American author of Indian origin, Jhumpa Lahiri, published in 1999. The story tells about the lives of Indian and Indian Americans. The main characters in the story are Mr. Kepasi, Mr. and Mrs. Das, and their three children, Bobby, Roni, and Tina. The story tells about the lives of Indian and Indian Americans. The Das family is in India on vacation. Mr. Das has hired Mr. Kepasi to drive them to the, visit the son's temple. The family sits in the car, which stops near its tea stall. Mr. and Mrs. Das argue that who will take their child Tina to the bathroom. Ultimately, Mrs. Das takes her. Mr. Kepasi notices the parents' immaturity. Mr. and Mrs. Das looks and act young, pointing out the childishness. Their children seem selfishly indifferent to the kids. On their trip, her husband and the children get out of the car for the sightseeing. Mrs. Das sits in the car and she was eating snacks without offering to anyone else, and she was wearing a sunglasses as a barrier and painting her nails. Mr. and Mrs. Das asked Mr. Kepasi about her job. Then he says that he was a tourist guide and he has a job as a weekdays as an interpreter in the doctor's office. Mrs. Das points out that the health of the patient depends upon the Mr. Kepasi's correct interpretation of their melodies. Mr. Das developed a romantic interest upon Mrs. Mr. Kepasi developed a romantic interest on Mrs. Das and conducted several conversations on their journey. Then she tells about her secret that she had an affair and Bobby had been born of her adultery. This disappointed Mr. Kepasi, and he pointed her guilt, and she storms off, and she went to her parents near to her family. At that time, the snacks which was there on her hand falls down, and the monkeys attacked Bobby, and they followed. These monkeys followed Mrs. Das, and they attacked Bobby. Mr. Kepasi helped Bobby, and Mr. and Mrs. Das cleaned him up. So this was the end of the story, and here. The view is everything is on the Mr. Kepasi's perspective, and the theme of the story is that culture and the identity, and also the language and the communication. Thank you.
Hello everyone. So I am here to discuss the characters of Interpreter of Melodies by Jhumpa Lahiri. So, hope you guys already heard about the characters in the previous section of this video. Now, I am going to discuss these characters in detail. So, there are three main characters in this story. First one, Mr. Kepasi, the protagonist of the story, Mr. Das and Mrs. Das. And remaining characters were the three children of Mr. and Mrs. Das. So, moving on to first character, Mr. Kepasi. As I mentioned earlier, he is the protagonist of the story, and he is working as an interpreter for a doctor and a tourist guide. He is 46 years old, smart Indian man, and he wears a grey colored trousers and a matching jacket. So this is the uniform, this is the preferred uniform for his tourist guide. And so this is the physical appearance of Mr. Kapasi. Moving on, we can say that he believes that his life is very failure and he longs something more. When we read the text, we can clearly understand that he develops a far-fetched fantasy about the possibilities of deep friendship between himself and Mrs. Das. This fantasy reveals how his life is lonely and his marriage have become. Talking about the marriage of Mr. Kapasi, it was an arranged marriage and he's struggling with his wife because she cannot forgive him or she cannot recover from the grief of losing their son. She cannot forgive him to work with a doctor who cannot save their son. So this is the condition of Mr. Kapasi's life. On this isolation of his life, he finds Mrs. Das, and he sees Mrs. Das as a kinder spirit because she also languishes in a loveless marriage. Then he imagines the similarities between them that do not exist, yearning a friend in this American woman. Not surprisingly, this encounter ends in disappointment. When Mrs. Das confides in him, he feels only disgust. The intimacy he thought he wanted revolted him when he learned more about Mrs. Das' nature. In both of his jobs, which means as an interpreter for a doctor and as an tourist guide, we can say he is acting as a cultural broker, which means as a tour guide he show mostly English speaking European the sites of India, and as an interpreter for a doctor he helps the ailing from the another region to communicate with the physician. He is ultimately unable to bridge the cultural gap between himself and Mrs. Das, whether it stems national or more personal one. We can see Mr. Kapasi's brief transformation from a tour guide to a romantic interpreter ends poorly with his return to the ordinary drudgery of his days. So this is all about Mr. Kapasi. Now moving on to Mr. Das, we can say he is a middle science teacher in New Jersey where he lives with his family, and he is in holiday with his wife and children in India. Like the rest of the Das family, he has the roots in India but born and raised in America. Throughout the tour into the Sun Temple with his family, he is busy reading from an India guidebook and snapping pictures with his camera. He seems to be out of touch with his wife and his children, who often ignores his directions and challenges. Such reactions reveal that he lacks the authority or the respect as a husband or a father. And the thing is that he does not even know that the second child of his, Bobby, is in fact not a biological child of his, but it's a product of the affair of his wife with his own friend. So this is all about Mr. Das. And moving on to Mrs. Das or Miss Meena Das, we can say she is a selfish lady. The fundamental failing is that she is a selfish and self-absorbed lady. She does not see as anyone else as they are, but rather as to fulfill her is the misery she has caused. She hides behind her sunglasses and disengages from her family. Likewise, when her attempt to confiding in Mr. Kabasi, she leaves from the car rather than confront the guilt that Mr. Kabasi suggested is the source of her pains. So all from this, we can clearly understand that she represents the ugly Americans who disrespect the other nations, cultures and others' emotions. She embodies stereotypically American flaws, including disrespect to other countries' cultures and misbehavior of children, and self-involvement so extensive that she blames others for her feeling of guilt about her infidelity. She is a messy, lazy, and a bad parent. She has even no concern about the environment or her effect on it, and drop her rice snacks all over the ground, riling the local wildlife. That is why I also mentioned earlier, she is called as an, or she is represent the ugly American Americans. So this all about the characters. I believe that I followed all the main characters briefly. So hope you guys understood. Thank you.
Interpreter of Maldives is a fictional short story written by Jhumpa Lahiri. She deals with the cultural conflict. Interpreter of Maldives included are the difficulties that Indians have in relating to Americans, and the way in which Indians Americans are caught in the middle of two very different cultures. In the story, three main characters, Mr. and Mrs. Das and Mr. Kapsi. Mr. and Mrs. Das were both born and raised in America. The passers visit every few years, bring the children with them. They are Indian but not of India, and their dresses and their manner are wholly American. Mr. Kapsi, the tour guide and driver of Indian expatriate Das family, interprets their character in accordance with his Indian values, customs and assumptions. Although Mr. Kapsi recognized some common cultural heritage, Das are no more familiar with India than any other tourist. Mrs. Das and their children visit in a sun temple in India. They are foreigners. Mr. Das even seems to take pride in his status as a stranger, telling Mr. Kapsi about his American roots with an air of sudden confidence. Mr. Kapsi is offended by the concept of infidelity in Mr. Das' marriage. This lack of understanding reflects a differing understanding of the duty and family between the two cultures.
Interpreter of Maldives is a collection of 9 short stories written by American author Jhumpa Lahiri. Lahiri incorporates many symbols to help the reader to understand the relationships that are portrayed in the fiction. The symbols used in the fiction are the camera, the address slip of Kabasi, the sun temple, the Hanuman monkeys, the puffed rice of Mrs. Das, etc. So the first symbol is camera. The camera of Mr. Das represents his inability to see the world clearly or engage with it. He sees the world only through his camera. He misses the reality around him. He chooses to have Mr. Capasi to stop the cab so that he can photograph. He can get the photograph of a starving peasant. Wanting the photograph only and as a sovereign of India and ignoring the obvious need for help of that man. The world around Mr. Das is totally distorted because he sees the world only through his camera. Mrs. Das puffed rice is another element. The puffed rice of Mrs. Das represents her carelessness, careless actions and mistakes. Physically she is young, attractive, but spiritually empty. She does not love or care her children and husband. Also, she bears a secret which could tear the entire family. She scatters the puffed rice on the dwellings of temple without thinking the danger it will cause to others. Hanuman Mangis is another important symbol. Throughout the story, Interpreter of Maldives, Hanuman Mangis represents the danger threatening the Das family because of the negligence of Mr. and Mrs. Das, both as parents and partners. The Mangis first approached them while Mr. Capasi leading the couples and the children towards the temple. One causes the gate to break the car suddenly, which may be harmful to the family. The second situation is when Mrs. Das leaves Capasi after confessing that their son Bobby is the product of another affair. The Mangis approaching them because the puffed rice scattered on the ground from the snack bag of Mrs. Das. This also represents the danger lurking in the family. The Sun Temple is another important symbol. Sun Temple is a tourist destination in India where Mr. Das and Mrs. Das visit with their guide Mr. Capasi. The Sun Temple symbolizes that all these characters have roots in India in one hand, and in other hand it also shows the distance that kept by Mr. and Mrs. Das shows that they are more Americans than more Indians, even though they have roots in India. So next important symbol is a slip with the Capasi's address on it. A slip with the Capasi's address on it is an important symbol. It plays an important role. The first time we see that in the story is when Mrs. Das asked Mr. Capasi his address so she can send the photos of that trip they made it together. Here the slip plays an important role. It plays a long-term relationship between Mr. Capasi and Mrs. Das. In the conclusion of the story, the paper slip on which the address is written completely turns into opposite. So there are so many symbols in the story, Interpreter of Maldives, which played an important role. It helped the writer to paint out a vivid image in the writer's view.
Interpreter of Maldives is told from third person limited point of view. That is, the story is told by an objective narrator who reveals the perceptions of Mr. Capasi's perceptions, but not those of the other characters. Events unfold primarily as Mr. Capasi, not Mr. Das, sees them. For example, when the characters leave the taxi at the temple, the narrator follows Mr. Capasi, who walks ahead so as not to disturb Mr. Das, and does not show as what Mrs. Das is doing until she again endorses Mr. Capasi's view. Likewise, when Mrs. Das leaves the taxi to take Tina to the bathroom, the narrator stays in the car with Mr. Capasi, who waits alone while the boys and Mr. Das get out of the car. Even the character's name reflects the focus on Mr. Capasi instead of calling Mrs. Das by her first name Meena, as both her husband and her children do. The narrator refers to her exclusively as Mr. Das, which is over Mr. Capasi sees her. Likewise, the narrator does not disclose information that Mr. Capasi would you know. We do not, for example, even learn the exact ages of Rooney and Tina. We do, however, hear about how Mr. Capasi has only two suits. The better of the two is the one he wears in the story. By using this point of view, Lahiri limits the scope of our knowledge about the Das family and emphasizes the disconnection between Mrs. Das and Mr. Capasi. Although Mr. Capasi interprets Mrs. Das. Comments are flattering and even filtration. Mrs. Das likely did not intend her comments to be constructed this way. Mr. Kabasi wishes for an intimate connection with Mrs. Das, but when she finally does spill her secrets, her affairs, her true feeling about her husband, the heated beginning of the relationship, Mr. Kabasi is overwhelmed and disgusted. She was unaware of how crass and imprecise her revelation would seem to Mr. Kabasi, just as she oblivious to how insulting it is for her to expect him to have a cure for her pain. Mr. Kabasi thinks he and Mrs. Das have a connection because he recognized in her situation that spent spouse and troubled marriage from his own life. However, any connection between them is only in his mind.
Present paper tries to analyze cultural and social themes that we face in the fiction of Tumba Lahiri. The basic reason is that most of them have found themselves in such conflicting situation in their own lives. They were born at a place and then migrated to another country or land. There is very much different from their native places, and for as cultural and emotional perspective is concerned. Mrs. Das was born in India and her childhood moved to America. She almost her whole life in America, but in spite of that she could not detach herself from her native roots. Mrs. Das talking about Indians, especially Bengali settings surrounding tradition and customs of India. It seems that her body living in America, but her mind and soul roam in India. Another difference is that the cultural conflict faces relationship of Mr. and Mrs. Das. It is completely different from the life of Indian husband and wife. In India, we see the husband and wife don't express their emotions for each other. That in it doesn't mean they don't have the emotions or feelings. Jhumpa Lahiri also presents many other aspects of Indian culture through the medium of Konar Pemble, the character Mrs. Kabasi, and many others, which is quite different from those American and Americans. Mrs. Das was born in India and her childhood moved to America. She almost her whole life in America, but in spite of that she could not detach herself from her native roots. Mrs. Das talking about Indians, especially Bengali settings surrounding tradition and customs of India. It seems that her body living in America, but her mind and soul roam in India. The interpreter of medleys, cultural conflict, pointing out a simple example of successful cultural translation. Lahiri's characters reveal almost every phases of life, their migration from their native land to their settlement in abroad, and thus being four children, aspects of human life. The stories are the reflection of what Indian immigrants really experience after leaving the country.